When I first was introduced to welding, I was in high school. I switched schools and the new school didn't have one of the courses that I was signed up to do. And so in that time slot, I could do either welding or parenting. And I didn't want the robot baby to take home, so I did welding. And I ended up getting top of my class in that year. And from that point forward, I stuck with the shop classes. In my second or third year of shop classes, it was like, no, this is a real career. No, there's a real need for it. Like, you're good with it. And went to college for mechanical engineering technician. I continued my education and I actually technically have an ordinary bachelor's degree in mechanical and manufacturing engineering. So my first introduction to Skills Ontario was in high school, but while I was doing the machining dual credit, the Skills Canada competition was coming up and it was being held at Loyalist College for our local secondary and post-secondary, and that's where I got to learn about all of the possibilities of Skills Ontario. I put a lot of pressure on and I totally flunked out. And so after that, when I went into college, that's where I did the second one and didn't have the pressure. So I did the CAM competition. My teacher at the time, he was our CAD teacher. He was a huge advocate for skills, but from my previous experience, I knew what to expect, and that's why I didn't put the pressure on because it was okay. I was just here for fun and I ended up getting a medal. 15 years old, I walk into a shop class that is all boys from grade 9 to grade 12. It's a joined classroom, and that teacher, and he was just there the whole time. He was like, yeah, you can do this and you can do that. And do you want to do this? And I was like, okay. But then after that, it was Mr. Trevison, and he was a full advocate for high skills, major skilled trades for anybody and everybody. So it was the first safe space where I was expected to do what everybody else was expected. Because I didn't have pressure on myself to actually place and actually do well, I just said, okay, whatever, I'll just start over and do it again. The whole competition under pressure, keep moving, you know, regardless of what hand you've been dealt, keep going with it. Literally just watched a video about the first ever female plumber in the union, and what she said is just coming right to mind right now. And it's, you have to walk in the room like you belong there, because there's people looking at you like you don't belong. And she was specifically talking, like I said, about female in the trades, but talking with men as well, like it's the same thing. They can walk in as a young kid or as a middle-aged person, and you're walking into a new environment, you're learning a new skill, you're learning a new trade. You have to walk in like you want to be there and you belong there. And skills was super critical in helping me build that confidence to be like, you know what? I can do this. I am here and I will do it. Personal highlight was actually realizing that I'm good at something that I'm enjoying. My competition in skills was computer-based, which, you know, so I have that versatile background. So again, I think it's helped me to be well-rounded. My title when I was hired was machine shop assistant. So I've kind of worked almost everywhere. And so right now I'm doing the metal fabrication and welding, and I'm working with torches and bending metal and cutting. And the skills industry is a community and they're real people. And not just that, but like all the skills are transferable. If a machine breaks down, you know how to fix it. If your car breaks down, sure, you're not a mechanic, but you understand the concept of what a machine is and how it works. It's just empowering, at least for me, anyways. I'd say there's two typical paths to take getting into the trades. One is through school and education, and then you find an employer, sign up with an apprenticeship, and you know, become a full journeyman, or you sign up with the union. Either way, apprenticeship is typically your number one path. The most rewarding part really just comes right down to tangible results, being able to look at the project that you've completed at the end of the day or at the end of the week and say, I did that. It's not just a mental empowerment, it literally empowers you to be able to do more. Whether you say you can or you can't, you're right. If you don't want to do something, that's totally okay. But if there's like a part of you that is super curious, why not? Like, you can do it if you really want to do that. And so just do it.